Welcome, dear students. In this opportunity, we are going to make a review about the second language learning. We are going to review the most important theories of the acquisition of the second language. We are going to explain the three theories about the second language. We are going to start with the behaviorist perspective. The behaviorist perspective, as in the first language, consists of learners imitating what they hear and develop habits in the foreign language by routine practice. In this view, the learners are thought to relate what they know of their first language to what they recognize in the second language. The positive transfer is a result of similarities between the first language and the second language because habits used in the first language easily transfer to the second language. On the other hand, negative transfer is caused by differences between the first language and the second language because error results from using habits from first language and in the second language. The problems with this view of the foreign second language include that the fact that imitation does not help the learner in real life situation. Learners are continually required to form sentences they have never previously seen. A finite number of pre-practiced sentences is not enough to carry on conversation, not even within an instructor. Another problem with this view is that many of the errors made by foreign language learners are not based on the first language. Instead, the problems most often encountered by learners resemble errors made by children during the period of first language acquisition. As you remember, the behaviorist theory, we acquired the first language with repetition, imitation, drilling, and exercises. The second language acquisition with these perspectives mentioned the same. We learn the second language by imitating, repetition, with exercises, and with drilling. But when we are acquiring the second language, we have some problems. We have interference with the first language, and that's because there are some problems with this theory or with this behaviorist perspective. Mention that repeating, just imitating the learner in the second language, they are not in real situation. That's because it's very difficult to learn just with imitation. The second theory is the cognitive developmental perspective. In this perspective, the foreign language learners are thought to creatively use their skills to cognition in order to figure out the second language on their own. The learners notice a pattern and construct their own rules accordingly. They go back and change the rules if they are faulty. In this approach to second language acquisition, the learners benefit from their mistakes because they are playing an active role in the foreign second language process and learning first and how the language works. One problem with this view is that cognition is not only the factor that learners use to make assumptions about the language. It has been viewed that some errors learners make are based on rules on the first language. They are influenced by these rules are supposed to come to conclusions based on their cognitive abilities. Another problem is that it's not always possible to deduce what the foreign language learner meant to say, and therefore the error cannot be clearly determined. As in the first language acquisition, the cognitive perspective means that we have to construct our own rules in order to learn the first language. In the second language, this perspective has problems in order to know or the assumption what the learner want to learn. The learner, they don't know what to learn. That's because we have some problems when we use this perspective in order to learn the second language acquisition. In order to review the information processing theory, this theory mentioned that information processing model of human learning and performance sees second language acquisition as the building up of knowledge that they can eventually be called on automatically for speaking and understanding. Learners have to pay attention at first to any aspect of the language that they are trying to understand or produce. Pay attention means that you have to use the cognitive resources to process information. It suggests, or the information processing theory suggests, that there is a limit to the amount of focused mental activity we can engage in at one time. The information processing means that the learner have to acquire or receive more input in order to construct the language. There is a problem because the scientists may suggest that there is a limited amount of this input, that there is a limited amount of mental activities that we can engage at any time when we are practicing the language or when we are trying to process the information in order to acquire the language. The critical period hypothesis. This hypothesis states that there is a period in a person's life in which he or she must learn a language, or else language acquisition becomes impossible. The basis for this hypothesis is that puberty, the brain is already fully developed, and afterwards language acquisition becomes extremely difficult. According to this hypothesis, foreign language learners should occur before puberty to best results. If there is a critical period for learning a first language, then the same could apply to acquiring the second language. Studies have shown that before the brain is fully developed, a second language can be learned more easily than afterwards. However, many people have been able to master the syntax and vocabulary of the foreign language after puberty. The only conclusive evidence for the critical period hypothesis with regards to foreign language learners is phonology. Learners who have shown great ability to acquire a second language have not been able to overcome their foreign accents. The critical period hypothesis means that there is a stage from 2 to 7 years or 9 years where children can acquire the language without accent. After these periods, some scientists say that the brain is fully fully and it is more difficult to acquire the second language. Some children can learn the second language, but they have acquired some accents of the second language. Some scientists suggest that if we want to acquire a second language, it's better to learn this foreign language after puberty. What is this sociocultural perspective? The sociocultural perspective is the theory created by Vygotsky. He assumes that the cognitive development, including language development, arises as a result of social interactions. Primary among these interactions are those between individuals. Learning is thought to occur when an individual interacts with an interlocutor within his or her zone of proximal development. That is, in a situation in which the learner is capable of performing at a higher level because there is support from an interlocutor. The zone of proximal development is a metaphorical location of sight in which learners co-construct knowledge in collaboration with an interlocutor. The emphasis of this zone of proximal development is on development and how learners co-construct knowledge based on their interaction with their interlocutor or in a private speech. The zone of proximal development created by Vygotsky means that, for example, a child, if has the opportunity to interact with adults, this child can develop the language more quickly, faster, and the adult who interact with the children also acquire other social acquisitions. For example, the adult, or in this case the mother, help the children to learn not just grammar, not just vocabulary, not syntax. They acquire the language in the social environment, so the children can start to view the language in the social environment. This zone of proximal development is when children also interact in a social environment, for example in the school, in kindergartens, or when they are just also with adults. The Interact with Doodle permits that the children can acquire the language in easily, quickly, and the language itself. Thank you very much.